With the upcoming release of the IONIQ 6, the first ever dedicated electric sedan from Hyundai, based on the state-of-the-art E-GMP platform featuring 800 volts architecture that offers the industry-leading charging speed, you have to wonder what's in store for other sedan products from the sister brands Genesis and Kia. And we have received a report that the next G70 sedan, 2019 MotorTrend Car of the Year winner, would be underpinned by the very same E-GMP platform, and share many technical attributes with the IONIQ 6. For those of you who might be wondering if the next G70 would end up being another disappointment, as a rebranded IONIQ 6, we have the lowdown on what the next German luxury sports sedan killer could be. So, before we go on, we'd highly appreciate your support by subscribing, and turning on the notification bell, if you haven't already. And please don't forget to like, comment, and vote on the question that's presented at the end of the video. With the anticipated release of the IONIQ 6, there exists a sense of uneasiness. This discomfort stems from the disgruntled potential customers that are crying foul with respect to the design of the sedan version of the IONIQ 5. Unlike the IONIQ 5, which became an instant hit not only because it's built on the industry's most advanced EV platform E-GMP, but featured a sensational retro-inspired crossover design that pays homage to the legendary hatchbacks of the 80s and 90s like the original Hyundai Pony or Lancia Delta, IONIQ 6 design, upon the exposure of the prototype, was met with harsh criticism and even mockery, being compared to the likes of AMG Pacer and Gremlin as being one of the greatest design catastrophes in the automotive history. These harsh words are completely understandable though, as the IONIQ 6 was supposed to be based on the stunning Hyundai Prophecy concept. Of course, people didn't expect the exotic suicide doors, or the steering wheel-less cockpit to appear on the production model, but the prototype bore almost no resemblance to the sleek four-door coupe styling of the concept, and came to us with a poorly proportioned stubby body, and the unforgivable early 2000s style window frames and doors. In Hyundai's defense, what the Korean company needed to build was an affordable family sedan replacement for the outgoing ICE Sonata, but what the people seemed to have wanted was a Porsche take-in alternative. Sure, Hyundai could have tried to mimic the styling of the Prophecy concept, however, there were many obstacles that may have prevented the Korean company from doing so. First, the tall and stubby look of the IONIQ 6 is due to the fact that it's built on the E-GMP dedicated EV platform that resembles a skateboard, with the battery being placed on the bottom of the vehicle. Of course, it works marvels with the vehicles like the IONIQ 5 and the EV6 crossover and SUV models that are supposed to have the tall look, and can provide the flat floor that provides cavernous interior volume and design layout that enabled living space themed lounge style interior, which was offered on the IONIQ 5 and to be featured also on the upcoming IONIQ large SUV or commonly known as IONIQ 7. However, this inherent structural layout, which was seen as a big advantage when it came to building crossovers, but appeared to have posed a great challenge to the designers when designing a sedan. As you can see from the photo comparing the height of the crossover IONIQ 6 in comparison to the IONIQ 5, which is supposed to be lower to the ground, the height difference is minimal. This is understandable as IONIQ 6 was from the beginning supposed to be a sedan version of the IONIQ 5, and not necessarily a built from the ground up four-door coupe that takes after the Prophecy concept everyone hoped for. The IONIQ 6 sedan's lineage to the IONIQ 5 crossover can't be more apparent when we compare the interiors of both vehicles. Aside from the fixed center console, two E-GMP-based EVs share near-identical interiors. This explains why designers couldn't give us the low slung and streamlined body, along with a frameless window as seen in the Prophecy concept, which would have required entirely new structural engineering from the ground up. Luckily, it's reported that Genesis will take on the task of engineering the next generation G70 from the ground up. Although based on the same E-GMP platform as the IONIQ 6, to replicate the success that the Korean luxury automaker has garnered in creating the first ever Korean car to be selected as the prestigious MotorTrend Car of the Year in 2019, and giving the German luxury makers such as the BMW and the Mercedes-Benz run for their money, Genesis will once again create an entirely new electric sports sedan from scratch. Albert Biermann, who enjoyed great success as the director of the BMW M division before joining the Hyundai Motor Group, and his team of engineers that also creates Hyundai's phenomenal and performance cars, will embark on the task of setting a new benchmark for an electric sports sedan. They are to take the experience and knowledge that they have attained from creating the first ever an electric performance car, the IONIQ 5N, and apply it to the next generation G70 electric sports sedan. The G70 electric sedan is to utilize the power electric system derived from IONIQ 5N, which is in turn derived from the EV6 GT supercar. The power would be rated at as much as 600 horsepower from the dual motor all-wheel drive layout. Other possible power electric systems include the 430 horsepower system from the GV60 performance model, and the 320 horsepower system from the IONIQ 5 long range model. The battery size will likely be the 77.4 kWh unit as found in the other EGMP vehicles that can achieve over 500 kilometers or 311 miles in range. It would maintain all of the EGMP features as well, such as the ultra-fast 800 volts charging system that allows 10 to 80% charge in just 18 minutes, and the V2L bidirectional charging system. Whichever the power system and the battery, the challenge would be to overcome the space constraint posed by the design and engineering obstacle of having a raised underfloor, due to the location of the battery placement as previously mentioned, as the vehicle will still be based on the same EGMP platform as other dedicated EVs in the company. As a point of reference, Hyundai has a stake in Rimac, the sensational electric supercar company that creates one of the most powerful and fastest electric cars in the world, and the engineers can consider using the Rimac-derived core structural battery pack to reduce the vehicle height, but this technology may be reserved for the creation of the Genesis GT90 supercar, which is planned to be a hydrogen fuel cell and battery electric hybrid vehicle. Regardless, Genesis designers will attempt to pull off their magic once again and create a masterpiece based on the breathtaking Genesis X concept. The Genesis X concept was created to show Genesis' direction and design theme for the future models, and not necessarily to create the next sports coupe. The first beneficiary of this stunning design theme will be the next generation Genesis G90 flagship sedan. Planned as an internal combustion engine car from the onset, the all-new G90 will be the last ICE model that Genesis will ever launch. Although an electrified version is also planned for the Mercedes-Benz S-Class and the BMW 7 Series Fighter, the first dedicated electric car to receive the X-concept design theme will be the all-new second-generation G70. As you can see from the rendering by New York Mammoth, it features all design elements of the X-concept with the trademark two-line lighting element that extends around the front headlamp, and continue through the front wheel arch to the door cut, eventually ending up in the rear twin wrap-around tail lamps. It also features the iconic G-Matrix grille in the most dramatic and expressive way ever seen. The proportions are classic GT cars with wide fenders and clean and uncluttered surfaces, not unlike the Kia Stinger, the greatest grand tourer ever produced by the Korean automaker, which could be reincarnated as a result of the creation of the next generation G70. The current Stinger as an ICE car, which was also co-developed with the current G70, is to be terminated in early 2022, but it won't be long before we may be able to see a G70-derived electric Stinger, as the all-new Genesis electric sedan is expected to make its introduction as early as 2023. The all-new electric G70 won't be cheap, as the estimated starting price will be in the high $50,000 range, with the top-of-the-line 600-horsepower model expected to approach $80,000. However, as the new benchmark in the electric sports sedan realm, and considering that the BMW M3 competition with 503 horsepower costs $80,000 right now, it could be seen as a bargain in relative terms. With the futuristic and sporty interior featuring the Genesis exclusive crystal sphere drive-by-wire shift mechanism, and the industry-leading Level 3 self-driving system, in addition to the innovative wireless charging technology that is to make its first introduction in the GV60 crossover, it would certainly make it for a very desirable car for those that can afford one, especially if you have been yearning for an EV with the Prophecy Concept's flamboyance. For the end of the video question, would you consider choosing the 600 horsepower, $80,000 Genesis G70 electric hyper-performance sedan, over the current king of the road BMW M3, or Mercedes AMG C63? Please vote and share your views by clicking on the link in the comment section below. Thank you for watching AutoVision, your best source for the fastest Korean car news and rumors. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe and click on the notification bell. Also, don't forget to join our forum and share your passion for Korean cars at koreancarnews.com. See you next time with the latest Korean car news.